Alright, this is a 1v1. It's nice getting a little variety. So various Varley, I don't know where to start with that. And a Dorfield. Two pretty solid players. Let's see what happens. Some good carbon, some good iron. Water is a bit scattered and weak. So this will be important. This is... it's close enough to that iron to be very nice, this spot here. So yeah, they're definitely fans to work with. Not having the silicon access up top might be difficult. It's glass colony. So I guess I would probably prefer the robot down here. No, scab up here is perfectly fine. A scavenger HQ has been found. This is stronger carbon, but it's so much farther from the water. I'm not sure it's worth it. It is much closer to the aluminum, though, so maybe. Yeah, this is a nice found. Although, yeah, that's fine, the positioning. Need to sell that down. Come on, sell down those 10 units. Only need 10. Have the upgrade. No, you wouldn't quite have the upgrade, but now you would. Come on. Anyway, yeah, this start is okay. I think I prefer just iron double steel. You already bought up the aluminum, but it's not a big difference. Other thing, maybe just go two steel. Ignore iron for now. I can't. You did drop on enough iron that you crashed out the price. So that wasn't entirely necessary right off the bat. Let's see, what's gonna happen next? Quarry glass? That would be nice. It does mean you're a little light on steel, but that's probably fine. You can survive. Need to do something, though. Probably prefer iron steel. What's the door field up to? Took the carbon, took aluminum on HQ1. Where's... okay, he took water. Okay, makes sense. Alright, even... I don't know. Going into power. I don't know if I like that one. Gotta make sure your buildings are running. A lot of that stuff. Yeah, this is definitely a problem. Okay, that cell did come. Gotta make sure the buildings are running. Gotta get down the other furnace. Getting the goon is also nice, but... don't know if I'd place that much of a priority on it. And the reason I'm kind of iffy on these turbines, well, a lot of reasons, honestly. Power didn't start high enough. Power isn't getting consumed by the colony. The power price is already dropping because of the two turbines. It's just very awkward. It's not like Various Varley was really shipping all that much. Power wasn't going to be rising like that. I hate this geotherm for similar reasons. Power's already going down. Let your opponent be the one just chewing through his debt and being kind of stuck with no money. I guess sitting on the glass is a good choice. Does prevent... the scavenger HQ has been upgraded. It does make that more expensive, but... there was no spike, so I guess Odorfield did pre-buy the glass. Oh, now this is something to take advantage of. Where is this claim going? I don't see silicon there. Oh, there it is. Did not see that high. But yeah, at this point, yeah, definitely set out of the glass, spike silicon, or upgrade, whichever. Need more steel at this point. Getting into water is fine. Would like to see farms at some point. I think more steel is more important. But yeah, we see what's happened to power this game. Neither player ever got into any position to make money off power. They're just keeping debt somewhat low. And they committed so much early resources to do that. A nice freeze, I guess. It's gonna keep him slowed way down for a long time. I think especially after that freeze, you do go into iron steel. Because you need the steel online. This is... You need too much steel and the price is too high for you to be out of steel. And even if you're not going to do that, well, single farm is definitely not the answer. Single farm on this side, too. It's kind of baffling. I get the decision from Midorfield to go into glass himself. It makes sense in a lot of ways. Stops your opponent from monopolizing that market. It's something to clearly be worried about due to the colony. But it does mean that he committed three claims to that for a marginally profitable resource. And he's meanwhile accumulating all this life support debt. And not making money from those really valuable markets. But he still gets the HQ4 first, he gets all those farms down. Life is okay. At this point, with your opponent in glass and, well, glass not being all that profitable, I would probably just get out of this stuff. Maybe just move into two steel mills there. Something along those lines. I think helping him push down the glass price isn't doing all that much. There's not quite enough money in glass at the moment to be bothering. See, he needs 27k, 9k there. Yeah, that steel freeze is just really hurting him a lot. The two steel mills just aren't enough to sustain any reasonable pace of upgrades. So even though there are all these nice markets, and even though you have to be very careful about crashing out steel and getting stuck as a robot, I think in this case it was definitely a necessary move. Really wish these turbines wouldn't be here anymore. After all I said about the early transition, fine, whatever. You kept your debt low because of it, sure. Now power's $2, your opponent has a geotherm up. Power's not gonna go out of control anytime soon. Do something useful with these tiles, please. So, I mean, you already do have triangles of that, you don't have enough water. So what is there to do? Yeah, fair enough. Fine. I did like that play on water, freeze that, pump up water, but still need more steel. Okay. More steel is coming. And now this is the price where the fun part of the game happens, because all the prices are super awkward. 1v1s and robots. Okay, Dorfield's going for even more water. I did talk a lot about how I hate taking third water claims, but that was really talking about FFA only. In the 1v1 setting, you can't really afford to have prolonged deficits. In a lot of ways, taking that third water claim is fine. Although, both players really need to be doing stuff about their life support. Okay, the goon went there. I mean, that's fine, I guess. Maybe prefer it right there. It's not a really any major difference. This prevents the most damaging steel EMP. This is the tile your opponent targeted before. You can maybe... I don't know. It's probably a minor difference. I'm not necessarily right in any way either. That's just a personal little feeling.
Awkward. So where did Varys start falling behind? It was a bit on the slow upgrade to HQ2 in the beginning, the not selling the electronics, being a bit slower to found. It was continued by taking the Geo HQ2. And then HQ3, the steel freeze. Yeah. And that's pretty much what adds up to Robot being that many steps behind. And you need Scab's upgrade quickly too, so it's not as if you're running behind an Expansive or a Scientist or something, but still. This optimization center is just really weird to me. Prices aren't going to get high enough for it to be a big contributor, at least not for quite a while. And it's a pretty significant commitment of resources. This, what is it, 120 carbon, 20 electronics? That's all stuff that could be going towards an off-world eventually. And this is a decent off- it's a nice off-world spot. There's dynamite, but you're the scavenger, so maybe you can live with that. Well, there are two goon poppers as well, so... well... we'll see. Dropping spies everywhere. Yeah, that's fair. Because he did see that there's a hologram purchase. Okay. The engineers have advanced our production. See, back to Varys. I mean, all his production is perfectly fine. I don't really get the goon on the water. The water was attacked earlier, and it was a bit of a problem then. And I guess if his water was attacked again now, then he'd have to shut down all his life support production. But water's just so cheap, and it was going to be cheap for a while. It's not going to be a high priority target, and if you're really worried about getting EMP'd and then having the water price spiked on you, just, you know, buy into water a bit while it's cheap, since your opponent's doing you the favor of knocking the price down so far. Oh no. The goon isn't a terrible decision, but I think it's just... there were better things to use it on. Yeah... 24k for that auction is quite steep. It is a nice off-world spot again, but... against the scavenger with all the goon poppers and dynamite, I would not be too tempted to go into an off-world there. If I'm gonna go into an off-world there, it'll be my second off-world. And in the meantime, that's 24k of debt on a tile that's going to sit off for a while. And maybe it shouldn't be off. 60 bucks a second is something, even though power is rising quickly. Did you get superconductor? Yes, that's what you have queued. I don't know about that. Guess it's fine. I mean, I don't like committing so much money into chems for queued up patents quite so quickly. There's some reason for it. If you queue all this up, then the chems for his optimizations are going to be more expensive. It prevents your opponent from trying to play with the chem price, knowing that you don't have chems down. But it's still just money that could be doing something. And it also gives that opening for your opponent to move into chems themselves and make lots of money. Well, not lots in this case, but some. It's little things. Neither player ever moved into more power. They got their early power, they crashed out power, and they're just kinda, you know, don't need to think about power ever again. Though, yeah, with Superconductor, 4 power per second isn't gonna cover costs. Well, no, never mind. Didn't see this second geo. Okay. I'll stop talking about that. I don't... What in the world? How did Adorfield let his EMP... I mean, his Offworld get EMP'd? I guess his goons are 40k and he didn't want to spend that or something? Goons are 20k for him. That's just inexcusable, then. Maybe he got... I guess... I don't know. Defend your Offworlds. When it's affordable. Would very much like to see the Dynamite dropped on it next. It is good that the spy is down. Don't know if he caught the hologram or he just placed it and it ended up being in the right spot, but either way. It's nice that the spy's there. Thinking Machines was a good pickup. What did he get slant drilling for? I don't really see any utility to slant drilling for him. Gets more iron, but iron was worthless and he was at a surplus anyway. He potentially gets more silicon, but silicon's worthless and he had plenty of silicon to work with anyway. He doesn't get any more water, he doesn't get any more aluminum. Slant drilling just doesn't make sense to me. Not even as a denial thing. All it would do for a Dorfield is give him way too much water. Weird move. But Superconductor is fine and good. Thinking Machines is fine and good. Perpetual Motion is a bit... eh. Other thing about gooning the steel mill instead of this one earlier, then you have a goon for your thinking machines. But, not a huge deal. It is a bit of a concern that Various Varley can't really buy more goons reasonably. 50k is a whole lot to spend with all these goon poppers available. Kind of moved himself into a corner. Even with Thinking Machines, this is, I guess, fairly cheap, but it adds up over time, and the scav can just keep doing it. Wait. This he has 88k. Not sure if that's counting the repairing Offworld still or what. Maybe it's counting... I mean, the patent value doesn't add that much either. I don't know. Either way, it feels like a bit of concern to me that he, Adorfield, buys up his own stock instead of attacking. I mean, it's not a huge deal, but it is a bit of a concern. Because Various does have a bit of a long-term advantage in terms of having thinking machines. So you might want to be ending the game quicker by just going aggressively, but I don't know. The Dorfield does have the short-term advantages, and defending himself didn't cost him too much. He can still get aggressive now. Just little things. This needs to go away. Actually, I changed my mind about perpetual motion. I said it might be okay. I know, I actually completely hate perpetual motion for Various Varley. Because he was producing 6 power a second. It's almost certainly going to be enough to cover... Well, not almost certainly. It's basically enough to cover production for the rest of the game. He is consuming 3.1 a second now, I guess. So it wouldn't quite cover him, but by getting it, you're basically ensuring power stays dead, and your opponent doesn't have to worry about that. Which, I don't know. I guess the Dorfield does have enough debt problems that if you never open up power as a thing, then that's also something, but it just feels like a bit of an unnecessary investment. Carbon scrubbing, probably fine. You don't have any access to carbon, your opponent's a scavenger. Long term, you're going to want to be have access to those two markets. Fine. But in general, I just can't agree with going quite this many patents in a 1v1. Just pick and choose a few crucial ones, then really you need your offworlds up more. You can't be affording all this spending on stuff. The offworld market is finished and awaiting orders. Still, he's not very far behind at all. He may still catch up. New building is available for option. Take a quick look at chat. Oh, I completely forgot to change my title. That's okay though. Yeah, starting to see his debt come up was the idea between the... That's probably a long time ago, that comment. Not selling down food if your opponent's not in it is perfectly fine. I don't know if I actually yelled at you for that. I don't think I did. If you were talking about me hovering over food a lot, that's basically just checking the value to see how close you were to the upgrade, if that would have pushed you over the edge. As nice it is as it is to like heap debt on your opponent and make those little investments, more important to keep moving forward. And I think you did a fine job of dealing with that. It's just something I was trying to keep an eye on. If I did yell at you for it, I would like to remember the context, since that might have been completely wrong of me. Also, hello, it's nice to see you in chat. One thing about what a Dorfield is doing that I am unhappy with, potentially. Or maybe he hasn't been doing anything of that nature. It doesn't look like it, actually. Okay, never mind. Yeah, okay. So it's basically a variest varlay giving a Dorfield network prices, which is perfectly fine. At this point, I might have switched over to circuit overloads just because those are cheaper, but it's not a significant difference at all. What I was going to say before was that for Dorfield, if he should not be tossing the network prices back at goons, because it's more important for him to keep his goons up than it is for Varys to have the goons knocked down because of thinking machines. You kind of don't want to give your opponent extra advantages that way. I also really don't like the choice of EMP over dynamite. I mean, it's 10k cheaper, but if the EMP knocks the thing down for 45 seconds, probably significantly less this time because of the diminishing returns from that tile getting attacked so many times. So the dynamite basically knocks the thing down for 30 seconds of repair time, at a minimum. You add whatever time it takes for the opponent to react, click the button, whatever. And it also has the repair cost added on top, which is pretty significant with steel being what it is. Our methods continue to improve. Though to be fair, Varys will recover all that steel money eventually. Along those lines, this should be a steel mill instead of an iron mine. You have this huge iron stockpile. Price differential so high. Okay, you're making that transition. Excellent. Yeah, fine. Part of me wanted to say that the Offworld should be under the Goon anyway, even though there's thinking machines, but Goon poppers are cheap, whatever. The black market is online. And there aren't too many more effects that are gonna get thrown around. So, slight advantage to the door field in terms of stock, but because of thinking machines, because of debt, I would feel pretty good about Varys Farley's position. Optimization routine successful. At some point, I think Dorfield needed to be buying up some of his own stock and paying off a bunch of debt to sort of solidify his position. Thinking machines isn't really an advantage anymore with stuff this expensive. I mean, it's still okay to use thinking machine, black market, but it's definitely marginal at this point. Yeah, by failing to defend himself a bit more before paying off debt, he's just doing a lot of good for Varys. One key thing to point out that I've talked about before. You see that both their stock prices are rising. Even though only a Dorfield paid off a bunch of debt. And stock price... stock owned modifier is based on the base price, and paying off debt increases your base price, so since he owns 5 stock, you pay off all that debt, you're spending all the cash, you're both getting the price boost. So definitely be careful about paying off debt in those circumstances. In this case, I don't know. If he bought up a bit more of himself first, then it's a better decision to pay off debt the way he did. The way he did it, it was just really not doing all that much for him and costing him a whole lot of cash. The black market is online. The way Varys should have this at this point. Yeah, Dorfield just mostly didn't take advantage of his position that well. Although, the question of what he could have done better is out there for sure. Because he did get the Offworld up, it was defended. You're against a robot who'll have the fewer cooldowns, but I think maybe getting aggressive, like I was talking about, maybe pushes things a bit. I think Varys would have defended himself anyway, and then that would have not ended up being a big swing. So where did Dorfield lose this game? That's the question to me. I mean, let's also first make sure I... Okay, now there's no specific questions about the game from Varys. So where did Dorfield lose the game? Let's take a quick look at charts and graphs. A lot of fuel auto purchasing. Interesting. Whoops, sorry about that. Yeah, I should have paused the game before it ended. Because what I'm curious about right now is how much was spent, how much water Dorfield had at the end of the game. Because he's clearly producing a large surplus, because he stopped, well, partially because his stuff is frozen, and because he's not
going all that deeply into life support. Thing is, water's a dollar, so he probably was selling down constantly. Maybe he didn't have any real stockpile. The point is, even though I talked about how three water is probably fine in a 1v1, that does mean you are almost certainly going to have a large surplus. Two things about that. One, you don't really want to be constantly selling, because that helps your opponent. In this case, your opponent didn't... Varius did not have a water surplus. He had a 1.5 water deficit. You keep water a bit higher, makes it harder for him to make this profit. So that's one thing. The other thing is, if you keep a large stockpile, well, once the fuel price starts creeping up, or once you notice you have over 1k water and that's kind of pointless, then, you know, you can just turn these off for a while, or a lot of other things. If you want to go for teleportation, you can make these something else. I don't really recommend that. They're just a bit too far away for that, and water's a bit too important for you to commit to the longer term transition. Anyway, so yeah, just turn them off for a while, save yourself the fuel, and just wait for water to be relevant again instead of killing yourself with that. That's a pretty big part of the game. It's 169k in fuel auto purchasing. Without the debt problems, I think a Dorfield is in a much stronger position. And that also fueled a lot of Varys Varley's money. That is a pretty sizable chunk of cash, the 127k net. Where else did... Glass money is fine. I think the move into steel was fine too, even by a Dorfield. Made a lot of money very quickly off of it. Did make steel cheaper, but can't really say no to 100k. So, I don't know. I don't see any other big numbers that stick out on this chart. It's really just the fuel that's a big swing there. Look at how much was sold Offworld. About even. Varys actually got a bit of an advantage, even though Dorfield had the first Offworld up for so much longer, even though he got the second Offworld up sooner. Making machines is good. Once Dorfield saw that the game was going to last a long time, maybe trying to contest the patents would have been very important. We can look at optimizations. This is all a bit... This is seriously questionable. I mean, we saw before that Dorfield did make a lot of money on steel, and this was part of a lot of money he made. But long term, steel money's not really going to be there, and you're also not going to have enough iron to support the steel. Did he actually pick up iron? I think he did. Yeah, I don't like the iron pickup either. Is that the point you're spending that extra claim to get the iron to support your steel? You're really losing a lot of the claim advantage you get from being the carbon-based scavenger. And since you're spending all those claims to really just lower the price of your opponent's construction and upgrade resources, it's not really much of a benefit to you. If there's a large price differential, you can go into steel pretty quickly, pick up a bit of, just buy a bit of iron, make a bit of quick money, then get out of it. I don't like the long-term play of that. And that also added to the fuel problems. This also added to the fuel problems, but I think that was more of a necessary play. Though, Colony never did get into more warehouses, so ended up being less of a factor than it might have been. Oh no, yeah, I don't feel like there's much more to say about that. It is a bit of a weird spot these days. I'm not quite sure what I think about the patent lab now. I don't think I've played enough since patent prices were adjusted for a number of players. It's definitely a more viable building now. And maybe it should have been more of a priority for someone with a lead, but not enough of a lead to make it a short game. Anyway, that's all I have to say about this game. So thank you all for watching.